Hi everyone, welcome to Hatha Yoga. Let's get started with a pillow or rolled up blanket, sort of this shape. And we'll lay it across the rear end of your mat, just about a foot away from the rear, so that you can lie down, draping your shoulders off the back end of that pillow and just letting your head either rest on the floor or just hang upside down a bit. So the purpose is just to help open up the front of your shoulders, your chest, so you can bend your knee, your elbows apart, sort of like a cactus shape with your arms, the palms turned up. If your lower back is feeling a bit tender in this position, you could bend your knees, maybe drop the knees together. So take any comfortable position with your legs. As we just allow a moment here to arrive mentally and physically. So with the support to lift your chest, allow your lungs to feel a bit more expansive, welcoming the breath. Here's a quote from mindfulness teacher Pema Chodron in her book, The Wisdom of No Escape. Meditation is about seeing clearly the body that we have, the mind that we have, the domestic situation that we have, the job that we have, and the people who are in our lives. It's about seeing how we react to all these things. It's seeing our emotions and thoughts just as they are right now, in this very moment, in this very room, on this very seat. It's about not trying to make them go away, not trying to become better than we are, but just seeing clearly with precision and gentleness. The very first Yoga Sutra in the Yoga Sutras of Patanjali is in Sanskrit, Atha Yoga Anushasanam. And that means now begins the practice of yoga. And it really just alludes to the power of now. When you're in a conversation with someone, now begins the practice of yoga. When you're driving in traffic, now begins the practice of yoga. When you're sitting at home, now begins the practice of yoga. So it really is being in this moment with your breath, with your thoughts, just as they are. Just as you're lying here now, just feeling into what's present in your body, what have you been carrying in your body throughout the day, or what has accumulated energetically and physically. And without having to interpret it with a mind just now, just allowing yourself to directly experience what is. So let's utilize the physical asanas, the postures of yoga, the movements, to really just be in direct experience with what is. Feeling your breath and just noticing, where do you feel your breath as you inhale a little slower? And as you exhale, a little deeper. A few more rounds of exhaling through your mouth, maybe even releasing a sound. So allowing each posture to be a means of just experimenting with where you are in that moment, mentally and physically. Little adjustments in the poses. What is the direct experience of that? And now let's start to step your feet on the ground if they're not already there, knees bent. And whether you turn over to one side or rock forward, please find a comfortable seat. And what an appropriate chant that's being sung right now in the background. Asatoma Sat Gamaya. Tamasoma Jyotir Gamaya. Amritam Gamaya. So bringing your palms together, your heart, the meaning of this chant is basically that, to see more clearly, to come from darkness to light. And so we open this practice, chanting one om, lengthening the breath. Take a deep inhale. Om. And really feeling into your breath more deeply as you use your diaphragm, breathing into your belly, breathing into the four walls of your ribcage. And if you can, just exhaling through your nose. So everything through the nose, mouth closed. Begin a breathing technique called Bhastrika Pranayama, or bellows breath, in which we help to cleanse and enliven the lungs. So with it, there's a physical movement in which you bend your elbows apart to the height of your shoulders, sitting up tall, and hands like this. And as you inhale, you raise your arms straight up, keeping the shoulders relaxed, the fingers spread. And as you exhale, you bend your elbows, refist your hands at a rhythm that's sort of quick that you can maintain for about a minute. Like this. So deep inhales, complete exhales, equal in, equal out. And I'm gonna set the timer for this practice of bellows breath for 1 minute. So let's prepare, ready, and begin. Last 15 seconds. Then relax, just breathing naturally. Pause and observe any effects of that breathing technique. It's also known to help clear any clouds in the mind. And then I invite you to ease into long, equal inhales and exhales, still just through your nose, while softly narrowing the back of your throat, so that you're creating a gentle whisper using Ujjayi Pranayama, or victorious breathing. So taking your time to reach the full length of each inhale, each exhale. Slowly make your way down onto hands and knees to prepare for downward facing dog. So when you're on your hands and knees, have your wrists under your shoulders, have your knees a couple inches behind your hips, feet about hips width apart, and then tucking your toes, lift your hips up and back, spread your fingers wide on the ground. Then you might take the first few breaths to pedal your feet slowly in place, helping to warm up the backs of your legs. Maybe also softly shaking your head, nodding your head a few times to completely relax your neck. As you root down, especially at the base of each thumb and index finger, find a slight grip underneath each fingertip while rotating your triceps or your outer upper arms towards the floor so that you're broadening across your shoulders. And as you completely drop your head, notice if it might be helpful to bend your knees any amount so that you can truly lift your tailbone to its highest height while pressing the tops of your thigh bones back. And then sinking your heels as close to the ground as it allows that long spine. It's okay if the heels don't touch the floor. Steady your gaze on one spot. Let's take three more breaths here, just listening in on the quality of your breathing. And on your next exhale, slowly walk your hands back to meet your feet, forward folding at the rear of your mats. Pressing onto the ground ahead or on your shins, shift more weight towards the front of your heels. And as you firmen your belly, inhale, lift your chest and draw the crown of your head forward, rising halfway. Exhale, fold in. As you root down through your feet, maybe bending the knees a little, inhale, sweep your arms and rise all the way up. Watch your palms meet overhead. And as you exhale, trace your thumbs down the center line of your body, lining your arms by your sides, palms facing forward in mountain pose. Let's take a couple of rounds of half sun salutations, linking movement to breath. As you inhale, root down to your soles, sweep your arms up. In Urdhva Hastasana, watch your palms touch. As you exhale, hinge forward with a long spine. You can bend your knees any amount into Uttanasana. Press with your hands on your shins or the ground. Inhale, press your heart through your arms in Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale, fold again. Rooting to your feet, inhale, rise all the way up, look up, back to Urdhva Hastasana. And then exhale, tracing your midline, release your arms in Tadasana, mountain pose. One more, inhale, arms up. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise halfway, sending the shoulders back. Exhale, fold in. Firming through your feet, inhale, rise all the way, palms touch. Exhale, tracing your midline, back to mountain pose. So let's add on, inhale, arms overhead. Exhale, bow forward. This time, crawl your hands forward and come right into your version of plank pose, taking a few breaths there. So that could be with your legs straight, heels firming back, or with your knees on the ground directly under your hips. Make sure that your shoulders are right on top of your wrists, your fingers are spread, and you're drawing your chest forward, looking on the ground ahead. Belly is firmly lifted. Now coming down in this variation, on an exhale, lower your knees, lower your chin to touch the floor, look forward, hug your elbows to your sides, and then glide your belly and pelvis to the floor with legs straight back. Let's take a few breaths in a light cobra pose. Feel that your wrists are alongside your floating ribs. Ground firmly through the tops of your feet so your knees are not touching the floor. Lengthen your tailbone towards your inner heels. And as you inhale, broaden your chest off the ground. And just look on the floor ahead for a few breaths. Can you press your shoulder blades further down your back ribs and create space through all the sides of your neck? Notice your neck is not straining here. It's mostly your back muscles that are lifting the chest. You could even lift your hands to hover an inch off the ground and notice that work of your back. And then when you're ready, press the ground away, lifting into your plank pose. Draw your belly in to lift your hips back, downward facing dog. And now as you steady your gaze, let your body be still. Let's take three breaths here. Bending your knees, lift your heels and hips high, look just past your hands. After you exhale, hold your breath and walk or lightly jump to the top of your mat. Once there, press your shins to the ground. Inhale, rise forward. Exhale, fold in. Firm down through your feet, inhale, rise up, palms touch. Exhale, tracing your midline mountain pose. Let's take two rounds of Surya Namaskar A, continuing to warm up the body, energize. Inhale, your arms up. Exhale, bow forward. Inhale, press to rise halfway. Step into your plank. And as you exhale, you can lower knees, chin, or this time glide forward and hug your elbows to your ribs in Chaturanga Dandasana. Come all the way down again or flip your toes from Chaturanga and come into Upward Facing Dog where the pelvis stays lifted. As you exhale, hollow your belly, lift your hips, Downward Facing Dog. Let's take about three slow breaths. On your third inhale, bend your knees, look forward, and at the bottom of that exhale, walk or float to the front of your mat. Inhale to lift your chest, Ardha Uttanasana. Exhale to fold, Uttanasana. Power in the legs, inhale, rise into Urdhva Hastasana. And exhale back to Tadasana. One more, Surya Namaskar A. Inhale, sweep the arms. Exhale, forward fold. Inhale, rise forward. Either step to plank or float into Chaturanga if you feel ready for that. Take it all the way down, Cobra, or into Upward Facing Dog. Exhaling back to Downward Facing Dog. And then we'll pause there for a few breaths. Redefining length in your spine, openness in your neck and shoulders, and a steady gaze, drishti. Now, as you lift your inner thigh, try to keep your two hips leveled. Inhale, raise your right leg behind you. And as you exhale, softly step the right foot about 3 inches behind your right wrist. So behind your right wrist. And then from here, place your hands on your hips, micro-bend your right knee, firm in your belly, and lead with your chest, inhaling to rise all the way up to stand. So we're getting ready for pyramid pose. Right now, I feel like this is a little too wide of a stance for me. So adjust your stance where you can keep both of your legs straight, both heels on the ground, and both hips facing forward. And then bring your arms behind your back so we can open the chest. You can either press fist to fist against each other, hold opposite forearms or elbows, or bring your palms in reverse prayer, fingertips pointing up towards between the shoulder blades. And then spreading your toes, really root down to your feet and feel the front muscles of your thighs engage without locking the knees. Draw your belly in, and as you inhale, lift your chest and look up. As you exhale, hinge forward about 1/3 of your range and just pause there, taking a deep breath as you root down through your feet, slightly scissor the right hip back so your hips stay even and lengthen the spine. Exhaling, folding another third, just like that, breath by breath, and then holding the last third for a few breaths. Harjvottanasana. Now inhaling, lift your chest so your spine is parallel to the floor. Put a bend in your right knee, and let's prepare for Warrior Three with hands on blocks or hands on the ground. So walking your hands about 1 foot ahead of your front foot. Drag your left toes forward, leaning all your weight onto your right foot. Lift your left leg from the inseam of the leg, flexing the foot. Now you could bend your right knee any amount here. Draw your right outer hip back and tilt your left outer hip towards the ground. And then look ahead of your hands on the ground to help broaden your chest forward. Taking about just 3 more breaths here in Virabhadrasana 3. Now, you could explore lifting your hands off the floor blocks, maybe joining your hands in prayer, or reaching your arms apart. Now, as you bend your right knee, very softly step your left foot further back, as far back as you can onto your mat, preparing for Warrior Two. So aligning your right heel to intersect the arch of your left foot, windmill your arms open. So you'll see that your stance is just about as wide as your wingspan. Wrap your right sitting bone underneath your body so that as you're bending your right knee just over your right heel, you're tracking that knee with the middle toe. The left leg is slightly spun inward. Keeping it straight, firm the top of your left thigh towards your right wall behind you. And then notice the evenness and height of both your arms as you relax your shoulders. Lift up through the center of your spine. And steady your drishti, your gaze, just past your right hand. A few breaths. Now, as you root down through both feet evenly, straighten your right leg and glide your hips sideways towards the back of your mat. Reach your right hand horizontally forward as far as you can past your right knee. Then lower your hand onto your right leg or just to the right of the leg where your arm and leg are pressing against each other. Feel free to use a block under your hand, raising your left arm up high into triangle pose or Trikonasana. So in this posture, similarly, continue to wrap your right sitting bone under your body. Try to create as much length between your right armpit and your right hip and the underside of your torso here. So you might adjust the height of your right hand if needed. As you take a deep in-breath, feel the line of energy from your outer left heel rooting into the ground, up your left leg, from your tailbone, up your spine, and out through the crown of your head. Can you lengthen through that in both directions? Let's take about three more breaths. Eyes might be looking up towards the left thumb or towards your left wall. Inhale, sweep your left arm overhead. Look at your right foot. Exhale, let's step back to downward facing dog. Deep breath in. And just feel any effects of those small series of postures. Noticing your left and right side. Now, as you keep your two hips leveled, lift from your inner thigh. Inhale, raise your left leg behind you. Softly, as you exhale, step the left foot forward about 3 inches behind your left wrist. Spin your back heel down. Bring your hands to your hips. Little bend in the left knee as you firm your belly and inhale to rise up. So set up your stance as you need for pyramid pose. Both legs are straight, both hips are facing forward, both heels are on the ground. And then arms behind your back, whether fist to fist, holding the opposite elbow or forearm on top, or reverse prayer. Spread your toes, energize your legs, belly in. Inhale, lift your chest and look up. Exhale, 1/3 of your range, fold. And with the inhale, pause, re-lengthen your spine. Grounding your feet, squaring your hips, using your exhales to fold a little more. So just exploring your own degree of folding forward, where you can keep your throat open and your shoulder blades pressed onto your back ribs. What's here to notice right now? Place your hands on your hips. Inhale, slowly rise. Halfway, just halfway here. And then leaning forward, bend your left knee and we'll place the hands on the ground or on blocks to enter a variation of Warrior Three. So flex your right foot as soon as it leaves the ground. Think of lifting from the inseam of your right leg, turning your right outer hip to face the ground. You could bend your left knee any amount as you tag your left outer hip back. And then lift the navel as you would in plank pose. Lengthen the top of your head forward. So feel here that long, strong line of energy down the center line of your body from crown throughout your spine. Enter the inseam of your right leg and inner heel. Last few breaths. Feel free to play with variations in your arms. So bending your left knee, slowly land your right foot all the way to the rear of your mat and cartwheel your arms into Virabhadrasana 2. Align your left heel to the arch of your right foot. So as you're rotating your right leg slightly inward, wrap your left sitting bone under your body Stack your front knee right over the heel facing forward. And then feel the alignment of your pelvis so that its bowl shape is as upright as possible, tall spine. And while relaxing your shoulders, steady your eyes just past your left hand. Let's prepare for triangle pose, straightening your left leg. Glide your hips towards the back of your mat. Reach your left hand forward as far as you can, past the left knee, then down onto your left leg or just to the left of it, perhaps using a block. Right arm straight up. Steady your eyes in one spot here. And again, feel that strong line from your outer right heel rooting into the ground. Up your right leg. Up your tailbone throughout your spine and crown. Let your shoulder blades soften down your back as you spiral your chest to face upwards. Take one last breath here in Trikonasana. Then sweep your right arm overhead. Inhale, look at your left foot. We're gonna frame it with your two hands and step up to the top of your mat, forward fold. Bring your feet together so that they touch. Preparing for a few cycles of sun salutation B, we'll go right into one breath each movement. So with your knees touching, inhale, maybe graze the floor with your fingertips, sit back towards your heels in chair pose. Exhale, hinge from your hips to fold. Inhale, press with your hands, lengthen your spine forward. Step into plank or float into chaturanga. Continue into cobra or upward dog as you inhale. Then downward dog as you exhale. Inhale, raise your right leg from the inseam, keeping your hips square. Engage the belly to lightly step the foot inside of your right hand, spin the back heel down for warrior one. With both hips facing forward, inhale, rise up, arms overhead, Virabhadrasana one. Use the entire exhale to lower through Chaturanga Dandasana. Inhaling to cobra or upward dog. Exhaling to downward facing. And at your pace, inhale to raise your left leg. Keeping the hips squared, exhale, round forward to step the foot through. Inside left hand, back heel spins down. Inhale to rise, warrior one. Take the exhale all the way down through plank, through chaturanga. Inhale, cobra or upward facing. Exhale, downward facing. And this time landing there, redefining your breath pace for about 3 cycles. And on your third inhale, bend your knees, look forward. At the bottom of the exhale, walk or float, your feet together at the top. Feet touching, inhale, rise halfway. Exhale, fold. With knees touching, inhale, chair pose. Press your feet to rise. Exhale, mountain pose. Let's take one more, same sequence, Surya Namaskar B. Inhale, back to chair pose, Utkatasana. Exhale to fold, Uttanasana. Inhale, rise halfway, Ardha Uttanasana. Step to plank or float into Chaturanga Dandasana. Take it all the way through your vinyasa. Pacing with your breath to get to downward dog. When you're ready, inhale, raise your right leg. Exhale, step it forward inside of right hand, back heel spins down. Inhale, rise completely into warrior one. Exhale to lower all the way through continue into your vinyasa. And when you arrive at downward dog, side two, inhale to raise the left leg. Exhale to step the foot inside of your left hand, back heel spins down. Inhale to rise up, warrior one. Exhale to lower, through, into vinyasa. Now we'll meet in downward facing dog for about three or so breaths. Steady gaze, recalibrating your breath. And when you're ready, at the bottom of an exhale, walk or float your feet together at the top. Feet touching, inhale, lengthen forward. Exhale, fold. Bend your knees to touch, inhale to chair. Let's prepare for paritta, or a revolved chair pose. So join your hands together at your heart, sit back towards your heels. Notice your knees staying in one line, keep your hips squared. As you inhale, lengthen your spine, dropping the tailbone back. And as you exhale, hollow your belly and rotate your rib cage so your chest turns right. Inhale, lengthen your spine where you are, draw your left sitting bone back. And then exhale, continue to twist. Now you could press your left upper arm outside of your right thigh and add some leverage if you choose. You could either keep your hands together in prayer, center of your chest, meeting your thumbs, or you could open your arms wide. Let's take two to three last breaths here. Now, as you shift your weight entirely into your right foot, stay in your twist. Look about a foot ahead of your feet onto the floor. Begin to lift your left heel. We're going to transition while in the twist into a lunge, twisting there. So step the ball of your left foot as slowly as you can. So you're passing through warrior three and then arriving in a lunge. Now your back knee could be on the floor or it could be lifted, but just feel out your hips. As you let your right hip sink, bending the front knee over the heel, lift your left thigh away from the ground and draw your inner left heel back. About three more breaths here. Now again, look at the floor about a foot ahead of your front foot and unwind to rise up into crescent lunge, raising your arms overhead. You may like to bend your left knee if it's not on the ground here to help lift your frontal hip bones and direct your tailbone more downward. And then from there, maybe straighten the left leg. So think of your spine like a flat back. Draw your navel in towards your spine, up towards your heart. As you lean your torso forward, press your inner left heel back. Take a breath here, hovering your belly off of your right thigh. Reach for blocks or the floor, one foot ahead of your right toes, and let's re-enter that variation of warrior three that we did towards the beginning. Remember to spiral the inseam of your left leg towards the sky and tack your right outer hip back, lifting the navel towards your back. Draw your crown forward. Left foot is actively flexed. Check in with your breathing here. Now entering revolved half moon pose. We'll keep the legs in warrior three. Walk your left hand about 1 foot in front of your right big toe. Now you can use your right thumb to hook your right hip crease back so that hip stays in line with the left hip. Keep tracing the midline of your mat with your spine. Draw the shoulders back, breathe in. And as you exhale, begin to spiral your chest to face the right wall, perhaps raising your right arm towards the sky. Little by little, just experimenting with your range of the twist here. Breathe in. without twist. Harita Ardha Chandrasana. Finish off one more breath here. Then place your right hand down in front of you. Inhale to rise halfway. Keep lifting your inner left thigh. Exhale, fold into your right shin in standing split. Doesn't matter how high you're lifting your left leg. Just try to keep your hips even still, supporting your lower back. You may want to play with wrapping the right arm around your right calf or both arms around your right calf. Let your head fall. And then when you're ready, step your left foot next to the right into a forward fold. Press through your feet, inhale, sweep your arms to rise all the way up. Exhale, trace your thumbs down your midline and just pause for a few breaths in mountain pose, just observing. Tuning into your body, mind, breath, energy. Feel your big toes touching. And on your next inhale, bend your knees together to touch. As you join your palms to meet at your heart, inhale, lengthen your spine, preparing for a twist in chair pose. Exhale, rotate your chest to the left, little by little, experimenting with your range of the twist. Draw the right hip back, press the shoulder blades down your back. You might hook the right upper arm outside your left thigh. Choose your arm variation. So while you've gone through the first side already, knowing what might be next, can you still bring your attention to the moment by moment? Right here, right now. What's the quality of your breath here? Now gaze at the ground 1 foot ahead of your feet. Transfer your weight onto your left foot, lifting your right heel. Keep the twist as much as you can, and very slowly take a giant step back with a ball of your right foot, so that you're in a lunge, twisting. Know that you can land your right knee to the floor as well. When you arrive in that lunge twist, feel the re-squaring of your hips, breathing in to trace the midline of your mat with your spine. Breathing out to spiral your chest. About two more breaths. Again, look forward of your left foot on the ground. And on your next inhale, unwind to rise into crescent lunge, reaching your arms overhead. So if your back knee's on the floor, feel free to bend your right knee and just find the alignment of your pelvic bowl where you're drawing your tailbone downward and you're slightly lifting your frontal hip bones. And then maybe straighten the right leg. Feel into your body breathing here. Joining your palms together at your heart, inhale, lengthen your spine forward, just bowing towards a diagonal. Now feel the strong line of energy from the crown of your head down to your tailbone, down the inseam of your right leg through the inner heel. Try to maintain that line and place your hands on the floor or on blocks, 1 foot ahead of your left foot. Flex the right foot off the ground, entering this variation of Warrior Three. Tack your left outer hip back, rotate your right outer hip towards the floor, and lifting your belly in, lengthen the crown of your head forward, finding space in your neck. So imagine the feeling of pressing the sole of your right foot firmly against your rear wall. Keep that feeling of inner stability. And walk your right hand 1 foot in front of your left big toe. You might use your left thumb to hook the crease of your left outer hip back just to help keep your hips leveled. Breathe in, lengthen your spine forward. Breathe out, spiral your chest to the left, raising your left arm. You're in revolved half moon pose. Some tendencies in this posture is to crisscross the right leg over to the left lane that the left leg is in. See if you can keep your legs hips width apart. Another tendency might be to turn the head to the left, crossing into the left lane of your mat. Try to keep your head tracing the midline of your mat. So again, maintaining that strong center line, that balanced center. Last breath here. Set your left hand in front of you as well. Keep lifting your right leg from the inner thigh. And inhale, lift your chest forward. Exhale, fold into your left shin, standing split. You might play with wrapping the left calf with your left arm or with both arms. And as you're ready, step the right foot next to the left. Separate your feet, hips width apart. And clasp your hands behind your lower back, bending your knees any amount here. Inhale, lift your chest, look forward. And exhale, fold in, completely drop your head. Let's take two lion's breaths, cooling, clearing lion's breaths. Inhale deeply. Stick out your tongue, open your mouth and eyes wide. Make any sound. One more inhale. Tongue out, let it go. And then from here, place your hands and knees on the floor. Inhale into cow pose, coil your chest up. Exhale into cat pose, contract your belly and round. Twice more, your pace of breath, slowing down your breath again. So on your exhale, relax to a neutral spine and please prepare for 1 minute or so of your active inversion practice. That could mean downward facing dog, maybe lifting a leg and then switching legs. That could mean dolphin pose, setting up your elbows, shoulders width apart on the floor, either forearms parallel, palms face down, or fingers interlace like a triangular base. Draw your shoulder blades away from your neck. Now this is also a setup for Shavasana if you have your fingers interlaced, headstand. So either dolphin, tuck your toes, lift your hips up, maybe walk your feet forward, press the chest towards your shins as you lift the shoulders away from your neck. Dolphin, not bearing any weight on your head. Headstand, you place the very crown of your head to the floor. Back of your head is lightly supported by the inner webbing of your palms. And then you walk your feet forward, beginning to tilt your pelvic bowl slowly and completely upside down. You might raise one leg up, flexing your feet, and use that to help lift the opposite leg up until both feet meet together, touching, and you create a vertical line, stacking ankles over hips, over shoulders, over elbows. So in whatever inversion you're practicing, again, notice the quality of your breathing. And what's present in your body right here, right now? What kinds of sensations? What might you notice through your felt sense, the non-literal sensations? And when you're about finished, slowly make your way into child's pose, placing your arms anywhere you like. 3 to 5 breaths, resting in child's pose. And from your child's pose, extend your arms forward and let's slide down onto Sphinx pose so that you're lying completely on the floor, belly face down. Forearms are on the ground, so the elbows are just under your shoulders. Your chest is lifted off the floor. In Sphinx pose, walk your knees as close together as you can so we can give our quadriceps some space. Crossing the left forearm on the ground in front of your chest, bend your right knee. Backstroking your right arm, use your right hand to catch hold of the big toe side, the inner side of your right ankle or foot, not the pinky toe side, so we can also open up the front of your right shoulder. Then press down with your two frontal hip bones, completely turn your chest forward, drawing the shoulders away from your neck. And taking a few breaths, bring your right heel just slightly to the outside of your right hip while stretching your tailbone towards your inner left heel. You might explore even spinning your right palm at the wrist so that your right fingertips are facing the front of your mat as you're pressing down the top of your right foot, if that's available. Take one more deep inhale. And as you exhale, release your right leg straight with your two forearms in front of you. And take a few breaths in Sphinx pose, the regular version. Slide your knees as close together as you can. Cross your right forearm in front of your chest. Bend your left knee and backstroke your left arm. Catch hold of the big toe, not pinky toe side, of the left ankle or foot. Support your lower back here. Make sure that your knees are no wider apart than your hips distance, and your two frontal hip bones are pressing the ground. Then as you square your shoulders forward, dropping them down, bring your left heel slightly to the outside of your left hip. Breathing into whatever part of your body is communicating with some sensation. Now you might explore spinning left palm so that the fingertips are facing the front of your mat, if that's available here. Take one more deep breath. And on your exhale, gently release your left leg. Press back into child's pose for just about 3 breaths. Feet together. And you might want to straighten your arms forward here just to feel a little more space in your lower back. Sliding your hands back alongside your knees. Inhale to roll your spine slowly upright. Come to sit with your legs out in front of you. So from here, turning out your right thigh at the hip, cross your right ankle over your left thigh and flex your right foot. Plant your hands just slightly behind your hips. And then try to lift your spine as upright as possible with your shoulders relaxed. Just notice how this feels. We're going to take this into stages so you can see which stage you feel you'd like to stay in for several breaths. So one stage is to fold here and you can walk your hands forward. Another stage is to stay upright and instead bend your left knee and step the sole of your left foot on the floor. What's important in this stage is that you maintain that length in your spine, not rounding the back. If you are bending your left knee and you're sitting upright, Another stage to explore is to cradle the sole of your left foot and your right knee in between the crooks of your elbows, like you're holding a baby. And then from there, just straightening the left leg on the floor with both feet flexed. If you're doing the baby cradle strategy, you can even rock the baby a bit and gently sway your right thigh at the hip. Now moving into a potential compass pose, you could use your left hand, if you're taking the baby cradle version, and cross it in front of your right foot, feet are still flexed, catching hold of your outer foot. And then sitting up as tall as you can, drawing the belly in and up, imagine your right thigh is like a backpack strap that you're trying to put on. So the right hand takes hold of the right calf and just walks the right thigh up towards the right shoulder, whatever degree, so that you can place your right hand on the floor and use that to help sit up tall. Notice your breath here. You can always retrace to a different stage if that feels more suitable. Now, if you are sitting upright and you have that backpack strap of a right leg on, then you might explore some degree of straightening your right leg and spiraling your chest to your left, looking from underneath your left elbow towards the sky. And this is compass pose. So whatever variation you're in, notice how your body feels here and how it's directing you to the stage most appropriate for you right now. And just responding with love and care. Let's take three more breaths. Then when you're ready, slide your right leg forward onto the ground. Come to sit tall in Dandasana, stick pose. Legs extended forward, feet flexed, spine upright. So let's play with side two and just see where it goes, moment by moment. Turn out your left thigh at the hip, cross your left ankle over your right thigh. You can sit up tall here, or you can fold forward, walking the hands forward. Otherwise, sitting up tall, you might explore bending your right knee to step your right foot on the ground, and then really work on opening up space in your neck and shoulders. If you're sitting up with right knee bent, you might cradle the sole of your left foot and your left knee in between the crooks of your elbows, like you're carrying a baby, and straighten your right leg on the floor, working on sitting up tall there. Now, if you're in that latter stage, you might rock the baby and just sway your left thigh at the hip, loosening it up some more. And now, if you might be moving into compass pose, use your right hand, cross it in front of your left foot to catch your outer foot, both feet stay flexed, and then begin to walk your left thigh towards behind your left shoulder like you're putting on a backpack strap. Place your left hand on the floor, and then lift your pelvic floor and try to lift each vertebra from the bottom up. Find that spaciousness in your spine. Deep breaths. Perhaps to some degree, you straighten the left leg and spiral your chest to the right, looking towards the sky from right under your right elbow. Remember that no variation is better or worse. You're just experimenting. What's here? What's present right now as I'm experimenting in this asana and responding to my body. Let's take three more breaths. And then when you're ready, gently slide your left leg forward, back to Dandasana, stick pose, both feet flexed. This time preparing for Paschimottanasana, a seated forward fold. You may want to use a strap around the balls of your feet. Otherwise, grab your two imaginary straps from the sky, sitting up tall with the shoulders relaxed. With your exhales, hinge forward, and with your inhales, pause to ground your hips and to lengthen your spine. Now, if you're using those imaginary straps, let them go and walk your hands down the backs of your legs. Maybe clasp your big toes. Nurture an open space for your breath to flow through at your throat, at your chest. Let's take about three more breaths here. When you're ready, on an inhale, lead with your chest, slowly rise up. Take 1 minute for any last cooling posture that you may need to wind down for Shavasana, whether it be shoulder stand, if that is a normal part of your practice and you have no injuries in your neck, supported shoulder stand where you use a block or pillow underneath your sacrum and lift your legs straight up from there, or come into happy baby, maybe a supine spinal twist. Take your choice for a minute. Remember, if you are taking shoulder stand, lifting the pelvis off the ground, to protect your neck, you don't want to feel that you're flattening out the back of your neck onto the floor. Instead, tilt your chin slightly away from your chest and refrain from shaking your head no or moving your head side to side. Start to make your way down towards Shavasana. You might give your legs a hug, your whole body a tight squeeze, perhaps a couple last deep cleansing exhalations through your mouth. Let your feet splay out on the ground wider than your hips distance. You may like to turn your palms to face up so that you're rolling the shoulders back into the floor and down your back. And once you're in your corpse pose, close your eyes and let go of controlling your breath. Gift yourself stillness. A few minutes here. you'd like to join me for a formal sitting meditation practice for 5 minutes, please let your body begin to move, maybe keeping your eyes closed. Starting with simple stretch. Eventually, finding your own way up into a comfortable seat. Let your body feel comfortable, alert. You can rest your hands in your lap in the mudra of your choice. Some simple ones are Dhyana mudra to help focus, bringing the thumb and index finger to touch of each hand. Or neutral balancing one is to stack the palms, the center of your lap, and let the thumbs move. Just feel spine is tall, heart space is open. Either steady a soft gaze on one spot ahead of you, or close your eyes. And as we sit here for 5 minutes, recalling that those words of Pema Chodron, that meditation is much about seeing our emotions and thoughts just as they are right now, in this very moment, in this very room, on this very seat. And we're not trying to make them go away, not trying to become better than we are, but we're just seeing clearly with precision and gentleness. to bring your palms to meet at your heart. Any gesture to help you close this practice. Let's close together, chanting one om. Take a deep breath. Thanks for sharing your practice with us here today. The light in me bows to the light in you. Namaste.